Good evening, all. I request you all to rise for some time. Now I invite Mr. P.S. Samalraj, Chairman, Barpamsa, Tamil Nadu and Puducherry to welcome the gathering.
Good evening to all. Honorable Chief, Honorable Justice, Mr. T. Raja, Judge Madras High Court, Mr. Saravan, Co-Chairman, Barpamsa of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry, Mr. Michael Stanis Prabhu, a member of the Environment Committee, Mr. Bail Murugan, a member of the Bar Council of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry, Mr. Chandrasekhar, Council of the Bar Council, Secretary Mr. Raja Kumar, Assistant Secretary Greta Sajal Kumar, members of the legal fraternity, all new entrants and their family, good evening to all. As the Chairman of the
Bar Council of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry, it is my great pleasure to welcome our beloved Honorable Mr. Justice T. Raja, Judge Madras High Court. Honorable Judge, Mr. Raja was born on 25th May of 1961 in a small village, namely Tennur, situated at Madurai district, and he did his schooling in his hometown. After schooling, Honorable Judge did his graduation at Madurai. Honorable Judge studied in law. Law course at Madurai Law College and got enrolled in the role of advocates before the Bar Council of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry on 22/6/1988. After getting enrolled, Honorable Judge started his practice before the Honorable High Court of Madras and practiced for nearly 2.5 years and then shifted his practice to Honorable Supreme Court of India. And practice in all sides such as civil, criminal, constitutional, service law, and also practiced before the Central Administrative Tribunals and as well as the Honorable High Court, Delhi High Court. Due to his hard work and sincerity, the Honorable Judge stood as a standing counsel for various authorities before the Honorable Apex Court for nearly 10 years. On 9/2/2008, Honorable Judge was appointed as Additional Advocate General at Madurai Bench of the Honorable High Court of Madras. On 31/3/2009, Honorable Judge has been appointed as Additional Judge of the Honorable High Court of Madras and has pronounced several landmark judgments in which we can see the detailed explanation with regard to the legality of each and every provision involved in the issues. Honorable Judge is always thinking about the welfare of the legal fraternities and deeply immersed with the empathy of junior advocates, most reverend judge with the integrity and virtue. I feel great pleasure in welcoming the Honorable Judge who agreed to adorn this enrollment function which is happening on this day. Honorable Judge is known as a humility, scholarship, dynamism, and he is always supporting the cause of young advocates practicing in Madras High Court as well as the Madurai Bench. and his judgment speak volumes about the magnanimous approach towards the litigant public. The Bar Council is a statutory body which is doing a solemn duty in accordance with the Advocate Act and the Bar Council of India rules. In the Bar Council of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry, more than 1 lakh advocates have been enrolled and more than 75,000 advocates actively practicing. We are providing legal educations and conducting coaching classes to the judicial aspirants in the Bar Council premises in coordination with the Manidhanayam Free IAS Academy. We are glad to inform that recently 34 advocates have passed civil judge exam conducted by the Tamil Nadu Public Service Commission. Further, many advocates have been appointed as additional public prosecutor after attending our coaching classes. We are providing accidental medical claim policy to all the advocates and dispersing rupees 7 lakhs for the family of the deceased advocates as welfare measure. In view of the effective steps taken by the Bar Council, the government is providing rupees 3,000 per month for 2 years to young advocates who have studied in government law college, enable them to survive in this legal profession. During the pandemic, several advocates have suffered for their livelihood, and the Bar Council has disbursed more than 5 crore to the nearly 13,000 advocates as financial assistance. Today we are enrolling nearly 110 advocates in physical manner and nearly 930 advocates through virtual mode. I welcome all the candidates who are enrolling today as an advocate. This day is going to be important day for all candidates present here, physically as well as virtually, and they will called as an advocate from today. I hope all of you will serve this moment as special and work hard to achieve the greater heights in the field of law by following the guidance to be given by the Honorable Judge present here. I welcome Wonderl Hall who are present here and in virtual mode. I once again welcome the Honorable Justice Mr. Raja to this august function. Thanking you, thanking one and all. Thank you very much. All the best.
Thank you, sir, for welcoming such a huge gathering who are all present through here as well as the virtual mode. Now I request Mr. C.K. Chandrasekaran, advocate, to move the enrollment of all candidates.
It's my privilege to be the standing counsel of the Bar Council at this moment. The beloved chairman of Bar Council, our endearing co-chairman Saravanan, ever friendly enrollment committee member Michael Stanis Prabhu, and the voice of youth in the Bar Council Mr. Velmurugan, and of course our beloved judge Justice T. Raja. One thing our chairman of course was not knowing, but I myself came to know only now, our Justice T. Raja was standing counsel for Bar Council of India in Delhi, and he has represented the Bar Council in Supreme Court. Therefore he has more access to bar, and he is one amongst us from day one as a practitioner. Young members, I am here of course to move the enrollment on behalf of all the other advocates who have nominated you to become a member of this august Bar Council of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry. Just a few words before moving your enrollment in the presence of Justice Raja is that Justice Raja, before whom you are all going to be moved and stepping into the profession, this legal profession, as an learned advocate, because till yesterday you were students of law, you have become graduates of law. From now on you will have the credit of being a learned advocate once you enroll yourself and sign the sanat as an advocate to stand by law, uphold the rule of law and the constitution. You are all really very, very, very privileged, because the earlier occasion the Honorable Chief Justice of Madras High Court had graced the occasion, and today we have one of the most erudite judges, because he has had rich experience. He started from Madurai, as our chairman said, but he has travelled up to the apex court of India, and he has had practice in various fields. A man of such a rich experience, but when you look at him, look at his unassuming nature, his humility, in spite of having the depth of knowledge. So you are all going to have the blessing from such a great judge today, who is going to be amongst us and give us this special address on behalf of the Bar Council to all the young entrants of the profession. So I take the privilege as standing counsel
to move the enrollment of all the young lawyers who are applied for enrollment today, and I wish you all success.
Thank you, sir, for moving enrollment of new all candidates. Now I invite Mr. T. Michael Shanish Prabhu, Member Enrollment Committee, to administer oath. I request all candidates to please rise.
அனைவரும் உங்களுக்கு கொடுக்கப்பட்ட இந்த பேப்பரை கையில் வச்சு கொண்டுக்கிறோம். ஆன்லைனில் இருக்கிறவங்க எல்லாரும் ப்ளீஸ் டேக் திஸ் பேப்பர். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல் நான் ஐ என்று சொல்லும் பொழுது அதுக்கப்புறம் உங்களுடைய பெயரை சொல்லணும். எல்லாரும் அவங்களுடைய தனிப்பட்ட பெயரை நான் ஐ என்று சொன்னதுக்கப்புறம் சொல்லணும். ஓகே, ஐ Do solemnly swear that I shall uphold the Constitution of India and the rule of law, that I shall maintain the respect due to the courts of justice, judicial officers and members of the profession, and will at all times conduct myself with dignity becoming of an officer of the court in which I appear, that I shall at all times conduct myself in accordance with the rules of professional conduct and etiquettes as prescribed by the Bar Council of India, State Bar Council, from time to time, and as reflected in this noble profession, including ethical duties and moral values. Thank you very much. Sit down. அனைவருக்கும் எங்களுடைய தமிழ்நாடு பார் கவுன்சில் சார்பாக நேரிலே அமர்ந்திருக்கின்றவர்களுக்கும் ஆன்லைனிலே இருக்கின்ற ஒட்டுமொத்தமாக இருக்கின்ற 1000க்கு மேற்பட்ட வழக்கறிஞர்களுக்கு முதலிலே எங்களுடைய வாழ்த்துக்களுடன் உங்களுக்கு பிறந்தநாள் வாழ்த்துக்கள் என்று சொல்லலாம். என்னோட பிறந்தநாள் வாழ்த்துக்கள் என்று சொல்கிறார்களே என்று எதிர்பார்க்கலாம். இனிமேல் நீங்கள் வழக்கறிஞராக பதிவு செய்து விட்டீர்கள். உங்களுடைய பிறந்த நாளை கொண்டாடுவதை விட இந்த வழக்கறிஞராக பதிவு செய்த இந்த நாளைத்தான் நீங்கள் பிறந்த நாளாக நினைக்க வேண்டும். அது மட்டுமல்லாமல் இன்றிலிருந்து இங்கு அமர்ந்திருக்கின்ற நீதிபதி அவர்களுடைய ஆசீர்வாதமும் எங்களுடைய சேர்மன் அவர்களுடைய ஆசீர்வாதமும் எங்களுடைய பார் கவுன்சில் மெம்பர்ஸுடைய வாழ்த்துக்களும் அது மட்டுமல்லாமல் எல்லாருக்கும் மேலான உங்களுடைய தாய் தகப்பனுடைய ஆசீர்வாதமும் இன்று முதல் உங்களுக்கு வழக்கறிஞராக நீங்களுக்கு எப்போதும் இருக்கும் என சொல்லி விடைபெறுகிறேன். வணக்கம், வாழ்த்துக்கள்.
Thank you, sir. Now I invite Mr. B. Saravanan, co-chairman of Bar Council of Tamil Nadu, to facilitate the conference.
Very good evening to all. On behalf of the Bar Council of Tamil Nadu Puducherry and on my own behalf, I wish each and everyone who got enrolled today a grand future in whichever profession you have entered into. I mean that either you become an advocate or you later in your career you may be entering into judiciary, or you may be entering into any other law related profession. Only thing you need to do is hard work and you should have perseverance and a slow and steady growth in your life. Don't lose hope, have confidence, choose a better senior, continue with them for at least 3 to 5 years, improve your communication skills, and the sky is the limit for you. You should be very thankful for your family members for having encouraging you for all these years. Either you will be completing your 3 years course or 5 year course. And all the family members, your friends, each and everyone who have been supporting from you in all these years, I congratulate again for your better future. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for appreciating me and friends, for inviting Honorable Jed. I request Mr. P.S. Samalraj, Chairman, to present a book to Honorable Justice Mr. G. Raja. I request Mr. D. Saravana, co-chairman, to present a book to Honorable Justice. I request Mr. T. Michael Shanks Prabhu, member, member of the committee, to present a book to Honorable Justice.
Thank you, sir.
I request Mr. M. V. Muran, member, Parthman Sabunan and Puncheri, to present a book to Honorable Jai. I request Mr. C. K. Chandrasekaran, Standing Councillor, Parthman Sabunan and Puncheri, to present a book to Honorable
Jai. Thank you, sir.
Thank you all. Now I invite Mr. Honorable Mr. Justice T. Raja, Judge, Madras High Court, to deliver special address on professional ethics and ethical among young advocates.
Good evening to all of you. Mr. Amal Raj, Chairman of the Bar Council of Tamil Nadu. Mr. Co-Chairman, Mr. Chandrasekhar, Standing Council for the Bar Council of Tamil Nadu.
Also, but you are not afford to keep 2 lawyers one council.
Mr. Prabhu, Mr. Labour member of the Bar Council, very active member. Other dignitaries, guests, the newly approved advocates who are present physically here, and others who are watching through this virtual board. Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to all of you for having become part of this noble profession. It is indeed, today is, as Mr. Prabhu said, a reflective day to all of you. Mr. Chandrasekaran and Mr. Amal Raj came to me and they were asking, can you just come and thank you? Spare some time and share your experience with the newly enrolled applicants so that they will be able to take some guidance from you, sir. I was readily agreeing to that, and I take it as a privilege and honor. I'm really delighted to be here to wish you all the best from the day one, to become one of the legendary figures in the legal fraternity. you have from today onwards have become part of the noble profession. You have become part of the system that is dispensing the justice to all, irrespective of the fact whether you belong to one community, one religion, one sex, or one place, etc. In those days, people used to go to the law college only after they were not able to get admission in their popular subjects. In those days, they were not able to consider this legal profession as a rewarding profession, because they considered that the legal profession is lifelong struggle. But today, the situation is completely changed. I will tell you one or two very interesting and amazing factors. You will really feel that you are one of the privileged class in the society. Straight away, I can tell you, in the year 2012, why I am mentioning this incident is, today you are stepping into this profession. Many people must have told you why you have chosen this legal profession, because it's a very lifelong struggle you have to face. You have to keep aside, remove this idea. Today, the lawyers are commanding huge rewards, respects from every walks of life. Today, the lawyers are commanding huge reputation, goodwill, everywhere. Few years back, a judge from Punjab and Haryana came to us, Justice Vinod Kumar Sarmaji. His son used to come and then we used to share our experiences in his house during Sunday or Saturday. He used to all the time tell his father, "Father, when you were a lawyer, I was a small kid. Ministers, MLAs, even IAS officers, IPS officers used to come and stand and wait for you to get your opinion. But you become a judge. But all these clients have gone to other places. I don't know how I'm going to get back. Please retire soon and come back so that all these people will come back." A lawyer would be able to pull, would be able to captivate all creepy ways in the society. You belong to that profession. You must be proud of that. Today, the lawyers are commanding huge respects, reputation, goodwill every day, as no other professional can command this type of respects. You must know that. Beyond that, I was mentioning about the year 2012. In 2012, many of you must be knowing, perhaps the lawyer chairman, co-chairman sitting here on the dais, they will be knowing, there is a lawyer called senior counsel called Mr. Harisalmi. In 2012, it is on record, he was adjudged as the highest tax paying lawyer in the country. He was considered as the highest tax paying lawyer, because he has paid 100 crores tax as professional tax to the government exchequer, which is bigger than the income of Amitabh Bachchan, who is considered as a superstar in the Bollywood. We all say Amitabh Bachchan is considered as superstar, number one superstar in the country. But you see that who is the superstar? A man hailing from your noble profession, Harisalmi. is payment of 100 crores as a tax alone to the government exchequer in the 2012 is bigger than the income of the Amitabh Bachchan. Look at it now. So you must be proud of the fact that you belong to that wonderful profession, a noble profession. So you are welcome to this profession. Friends, many people say the legal profession is a noble profession. But there are so many rival groups, they also claim that we also belong to noble profession. Once upon a time, people only, the only lawyers claim that we belong to noble profession. But today, gradually, many splinter group also they claim that they also belong to noble profession. Doctors say they belong to noble profession. Nowadays, the nurses also are claiming that they also belong to noble profession. Teachers, they are coming with the innovative argument. We also belong to noble profession. The physicists, scientists, they also claim that we also belong to noble profession. Let us see the arguments advanced by the doctors and nurses. They say, you all people know, the moment the COVID-19 pandemic situation has wrapped up the whole community, the whole world, both in India, the state governments and the central governments have imposed lockdowns everywhere. You are not to be seen outside. You are not to go to market. You are not supposed to go to any bazaar or malls. We have come across a situation where cinema halls were closed, even malls were closed, markets were just open only for a few hours during the peak corona period. All children, elderly people, they were all cautioned, they were all warned, do not step out of your house. If you breach this curfew, you will become victim to corona. Friends, the doctors, they were told not to stay at home. They should go to the hospitals. They should go and treat the patients who are tested positive with the corona. Therefore, they say, when the people are all advised to stay at home safely, the doctors were told to go to the hospitals to treat, to see the corona patient. Our life were at risk. Our life, our family life were in danger, because once we were exposed to this thing, no doubt we'll be caught, we'll be also covered by this corona. Nobody knows whether we'll be surviving or we'll be going to the Meru. Taking the risk, we have saved the people. Saving a breadwinner in the family, we have saved the entire family. Saving the entire family, we have saved several families, and the entire community has been saved by us. Therefore, we belong to the noble profession, they say. We admit, we accept that. Yes, we are saved. Therefore, you belong to the noble profession. The reason being, you have taken the risk of your life. You have taken the risk of your family life. You have come and then treated the patients. That is one aspect. The nurses, they also claim by making another argument. They say, look, this doctor, they come and they diagnose the patient. Few minutes, they will be with the patient, they will run away, and they will prescribe the medication the whole day from morning till evening, even sometimes on shift wise. My sisters will be coming in the night, they will come and they take over their thing from morning, all 24 hours, 7 into, you know, all 7 days in a week, 24 into 7. We are all sitting with the patient. If the patient vomits, we have to clean it up. If the patient is unable to walk, we have to carry the patient to the restroom, toilet. We have to clean up, exposing to the risk of getting caught by this corona. Our life is also in great danger, and we have sacrificed. Our life has been sacrificed. Our family has been sacrificed. Therefore, we also belong to noble profession. We have to admit that an argument also. coming to the teachers, they say a teaching profession is also noble profession. And they simply say in true life, without teacher, no lawyer, without teacher, no judge, without teacher, no engineer, without teacher, no leader, no politics. So please understand that we are the source of wisdom. We belong to noble profession. The noble profession is created only by us. Therefore, please admit that the teachers are far, far superior than the doctors, because we produce a doctor, we produce a lawyer, we produce a judge, we produce everybody. Civilization is produced only because of us. We cannot deny that argument also. Now, the physicist term, the scientist, look at the light, look at the electricity, look at the mic, look at the internet, look at the Wi-Fi, look at the car, look at the aircraft, look at the train, look at the two-wheeler, four-wheeler, everything. Without these things, you will not be able to lead comfortable life. Therefore, without the existence of these technologies, your life will not be comfortable. Your existence will be a biggest question mark. If the light is gone today, for example, there is a power cut, I will not be able to speak politely. I will not be able to reach you. Today, with the use of the mic, with the use of the lights, with the use of this AC room, we are comfortable sitting. Your whole comfort is given by us. This is it. Therefore, your life expectancy itself is increased because of the comfort given by us. Consider we also belong to the noble profession. That also we have to consider very seriously. Yes, because we have to go to Delhi, we have to go to UK, but we have to go by only aircraft. That is invented by this scientist. Alright. Slowly the lawyer comes in about all these things. After hearing this, the gentleman comes and raises his head and he says, maybe doctor, maybe nurses, maybe physicist, scientist, maybe the engineers. Anybody can claim that they belong to noble profession. But you see one thing. There is a scientist who is considered as the one of the recruitment scientists in the world today. He is called Michio Kaku. Michio Kaku is a Chinese scientist, but he was born in US. He is living in US. The gentleman has proved Albert Einstein's theory, part of the Albert Einstein theory, as wrong. Such is the greatness of this scientist. This scientist said, today we are moving into the robotic age, era, everywhere. And he is predicting, he is giving a prediction, what is going to happen after 10 years. He says, maybe in 2021 or within a few years, the cancer is going to be treated as though we are treating the cold, cough. When we have cough, when we have cold, we don't bother. We just go to our office, we come to our work spot. We don't bother. We may take medicine, sometimes we may not take medicine. It is very chronic. We will go to hospital. We meet the doctors. A city patient is going to come. The cancer tumor can be just like that removed by using the normal technology. Cancer will be completely out of picture. We will not bother with cancer. All deadly diseases can be easily cured. It is curable. The gentleman says, which you have. And ultimately, he says, look at, before 1947, before we got independence, our life expectancy was only 40 years. But today, our life expectancy is in Tamil Nadu 69%. If you go to Kerala, 73. If you go to Kashmir, 75. You know why? In Kashmir, you get fresh air, fresh water, everything is fresh, unadulterated lifestyle. Atmosphere is so clean. Your life expectancy is more. Go to Kerala. There, the life expectancy is 73. People below 73 will not put to Venu, will not die. But if we come to Tamana, 69, the reason is we are just below Kerala and below the SB. He has been explaining so many other things. If you go to US, if you go to UK, and ultimately he is indicating in Japan, you know the life expectancy? People live for 110 years, 150 years, even today. Even today, people live more than 100 years. The reason is the atmosphere over there is fresh air and fresh water without taking chemicals. The vegetables, you know, prepared fresh vegetables. And he has been telling, in the years to come, people are going to live for 200 years. It is true. Mr. Abhinav is looking very surprised. It is true. I tell you how. Go back to 1,000 years ago. Sri Ramanujam was living here. If you go to Sri Rangam temple in Trichy, even today you can see his body. It has been found. It has been preserved. See, Ramanujam body is even for 1,000 years back he died. He reached. Yes, people used to say that he has attained mukti. I cannot use any other wrong word. He has attained mukti, leaving the body fresh. If you go to Trichy, Sri Rangam temple, even his physical body is still kept preserved afresh. But the gentleman 1,000 years ago lived for 120 years. When a person was able to live for 120 years, 1,000 years ago, do you think that it is impossible to live for 200 years? Today, with all these technological improvement couples, and then science, and then today look at it, within 1 year we are able to find out the vaccine for this corona. I got the corona vaccine now. Therefore, I am going boldly starting to go, you know. I am going for the second drops now. You must also go for it. See, then we are able to see in the entire world, today India stands number one. We are supplying vaccine to UK. We are supplying vaccine to US. We are freely giving vaccine to Sri Lanka, Nepal, Pakistan, other countries. They are feeling proud of being in front of India. I'm just coming back to the question now. The Vikshyam talk to say, people are going to live for 200 years. But one thing he says, give your favor, in favor of the lawyers. You may produce any kind of robot. We can produce any fastest train, fastest bullet train, fastest, aircraft. But one place where the robot cannot enter is the legal profession. And he says, wherever the interpersonal relations are there, the robot cannot penetrate, cannot be able to sow its head. Therefore, you are going to be the monopoly. Your profession, nobody can be interfered with that. You belong to such a profession. Yes, he is right. If there is a dispute, if there is a matrimonial conflict between the husband and wife, robot cannot come and solve the problem. Only a lawyer has to come and find out what is good, what is bad, and then they can counsel, and then they can bring back the reunion. If there is a dispute among the brothers in a family, and the brothers are going for partisan suit, only the robot cannot come, science cannot come and help, but only the lawyer can go and sit across the table and tell them, see, you, the second brother, you were educated by your elder brother. Do not fight against your brother. Give something more, take something less. There is something. Any reasonable person can accept it. So these are all the areas Mr. Vikshyam Kapu says, in the cases where the area where the interpersonal relations are all involved, the robot cannot take part, the robot cannot penetrate. Therefore, this is the only area where the science cannot penetrate. So therefore, my suggestion to you all is, you are the only person, no third party can come and reduce your scope of practice in this profession. Friends.
Now, therefore, the lawyers, they say that
Doctors can claim that they are belonging to the noble profession, but lawyers, they belong to the noble profession for several reasons, but one, the best reason is this, that we are the persons peacemakers. When people are coming fighting among themselves, scientists can fight among themselves, doctors can fight among themselves, the nurses can fight among themselves, the teachers working in one school or one college, they can fight among themselves for promotion, but the lawyers will intervene and then they will bring peace among themselves. And therefore the lawyers, without whose assistance the peace cannot prevail, the tranquility cannot prevail. We are the persons, we are bringing the peace to every nook and corner, therefore we belong to the noble profession, and this has been accepted now. Therefore, you should be proud of being a part of this noble profession. This is a noble profession. You being a lawyer, you must know that. Let us come back to the second facet of my discussion with you. You are a lawyer. You are an advocate. First of all, you must know who is advocate now. This is very essential and this is very rudimentary. You must know today before you step out of this Bar Council auditorium. Lawyer is a person who speaks for others who are unable to speak for themselves. Two meaning. One, lawyer is a person speaks for others who are unable to speak, number one. Lawyer is a person who speaks for others who are unable to speak but do not advocate use of force. Now, let me explain. Today, we have been sitting on the dais as a judge. Sometimes, it's a matter I must discuss with you all here today. Even a lawyer commanding, see, I got a standing of 5 years, 10 years. They do not know how to speak. A person who is unable to speak is unfit to be a lawyer. The meaning of a lawyer says that a lawyer who speaks for others who are unable to speak. But when you yourself not able to speak, then what is the point in saying that you are a lawyer now? Therefore, you must know how to speak, what to speak, before which crowd. Before the children, you should know how to speak to their level. Before the court, you must know to their level what you should speak and how you should speak. The Socrates, the great Greek philosopher, the only philosopher, and who has produced the Aristotle. This gentleman, he told the young Greeks, if you have to say anything to others, you must know how to say. Look at it now. You may have anything to say, but you should know how to say. A person is coming, for example, you are a lawyer, you have appointed a driver, or your clerk is there. If he's coming a bit late, you can say in a different way, why are you coming like this? What do you mean by that? You know the timing, but you can, at the same time, you can say, so you are coming 10 minutes late today. Do not repeat it. So how to say is more important. And this is how 2500 years ago, the Socrates told to you people, if you have to say anything, you must know how to say. And this has been explained so vividly by one of our sages, Thiruvalluvar, in the Iniyavai Kural, Iniya Ulavaga Innada Kural, Kani Yirupa Kai Kavarandattu. He said, see, if you have basket of fruits, in the basket if you have both ripened fruits and unripened fruits, a hungry man will come and pick up not the unripened fruits. He will come and pick up only the ripened fruits to eat, to just extinguish his hunger. Similarly, if a person comes and picks up unripened fruits, leaving the ripened fruits, he may not be an intelligent person. He will be only a less intelligent person now, a fool. Only a fool will come and take the unripened fruit and he will suffer with stomach pain. Similarly, when
Thiruvalluvar said, see, use the sweet words, do not use the harsh word. If you are able to know this small secret, and I do hope that you will become soon one of the seasoned, one of the legendary figure in your profession, that is a noble profession. You have to know minimum etiquettes, the minimum etiquettes, the minimum qualifications. There are several, you know, qualifications a lawyer has to have. You should be a honest lawyer. Honesty is one of the important qualifications one should possess. Courage is another important qualification one has to have. Eloquence, third important qualification one has to have. Industry, hard work, one has to have. If you do not have hard work, if you do not have that mind to do your work properly, you may not be able to succeed. Everywhere competition, cutthroat competition. But you must be prepared to work very hard. If your lawyer, your senior says that, yes, you have to prepare this counter within 3 days, you must be in a position to prepare your draft counter within 1 day. Only then he will be giving you priority. Only then he will be recognizing you, yes, this person will be able to deliver the goods. And then, after industry, you must have the quality to judge, and you have the quality to embrace your friends, your colleagues, and you must have the wit. See, I would just mention only a few things. When you go to the honesty qualification, you people may not be knowing, but most of us will be knowing. There was a legendary lawyer we had, Viruthachalam Rettiar, who was considered as one of the very legal luminary in the criminal side. I had an occasion to work with him. He used to send matters to Delhi. Mr. S. Sivasubramaniam, retired High Court judge, who shifted his practice to Supreme Court. He was a close friend of Viruthachalam Rettiar. He used to come there to Delhi. I was advocate in record. We used to have discussion. Friends, one day, during this vacation, we had to settle one SLP. Mr. Sivasubramaniam told me to go and settle the matter. Because I came here 4 weeks, I was just, we used to come here during the vacation. I went there to Trichy, taking time. I was sitting with his son. His son was, you know, very so kind. Within a few minutes, a group of clients came, wearing all white and white, carrying a big basket with fruits and then garlands. This Viruthachalam Rettiar's son, Patanjali, he went to his bedroom and then informed, some group of people have come, then lawyer Raja from Supreme Court has also come. Then he was just changing his dress, he came running to the office. These people, this group of clients, the smile was glooming, the smile was glowing on his face. They are competing with each other to touch his feet. And then one person just carrying a basket of fruits, just coming and then keeping in front of him. Another two persons went inside. They were just garlanding this gentleman. He was politely receiving the garland and also told, yes, keep this basket of fruits there. Then third person just took out a big pocket full of money. Well, it was not fully covered. I was able to see that so much of money these people are all giving, with flower and then a garland and then fruits. Look at this great man. It was a big surprise to me. And then he was asking, what is this bag? This gentleman, look at it. Thinking that this senior would be graciously taking this money. Sir, this is our additional fee, sir. And then he said, looked at them. I have received my fees, but I don't have the habit of receiving additional fees. Take it back. No, sir, it's all right, sir, we have paid you only small amount. Take it back, otherwise get lost from this place. Get lost. Friends, they were not able to say anything more. Two things as a lawyer you must know. These people, they do not know what to speak, what to do. As a lawyer, you are not supposed to advertise anywhere. You can't give like doctor or like auditor or engineer. They can give advertisement. They can put a big board. But if you put a big board, then these people will be coming and canceling your license. You are not supposed to advertise. But the only advertisement is your clients. They will be your brand ambassadors. If you behave with them politely, sweetly, lifelong, they will be your brand ambassador. And these people will go back everywhere, wherever they go. You have a matter, you have a case, and the safest lawyer I can give you, so and so, please go back to them. If you are going there, your life and liberty, your property, everything will be safe. Please go to him. That is the advantage you will have, provided you are able to display the honesty to your people. Honesty will pay you heavily. This is one such example. The second important thing is, in their lifetime, if you have any problem, they will never forget this gentleman. That office will be full of clients like this, and that can never be compared with any other things in your life. Therefore, let us try to be honest so far as your profession is concerned, whosoever is coming to you. For example, your client comes and says, sir, this client has to be filed, this writ petition has to be filed. Yes, taking into account the urgency of the matter, if it has to be filed within 2 days, and you must be in a ready to file within 2 days. Yesterday we were all sitting in the court over matrimonial matter. Appeal was filed after 5 years. It's a matrimonial matter. Look at the problem. The husband and wife were living separately for 18 long years. I said, 18 long years you were living separately, but why don't you make a try? Just give 3 months time, both of you live separately, away from your parental home. Then you come back and mention your problem. In case if you both of you are going together peacefully, continue. Otherwise you can come back, then we will give you whatever you are asking for. See, look at the problem. You must know that. Lawyer has created 6 years delay. He has received the papers, he has not filed it. He has not filed the petition. Of course, he has filed it and put it as SR stage. And then the husband, who is a chief executive officer in one of the banks, came from Bombay yesterday. Sir, of course, the 18 long years, but the lawyer has taken out 6 years' time. And I was about to go to the bar council, but then what happened? My lawyer said, leave this. I am bound by my lawyer's advice, otherwise he will not handle the matter. See, what I am saying is, had the lawyer filed it within time, this 6 years could have been reduced. And I would tell you what happened. There was a great failure because of this 6 years delay. 6 years delay, he said, no, this 18 years, you know, plus, that is 12 years plus 6 years, 18 years have gone by. What is that we are going to say? Friends, we should not be a cause, we should not be a reason, we should not be a stumbling block for two people to come together. I am saying delay defeats justice. Delay buries the life and liberty of the person. You must realize that. It is also part of the honesty. When a client comes to you trusting that my lawyer will be able to safeguard my rights, liberty, property, movable property, immovable property, my reputation, my goodwill, he is trusting you because he doesn't know what is the law. And he is bound to know only from you how to go about. When a lawyer, after receiving the papers, for 6 long years, if he is not able to present the papers properly, you know what happened? Had he filed it on time, 6 years could have been saved. Even yesterday, they would have gone. And we have given some time. Look at it, how difficult it is. Please do not delay. If you are giving time, 2 o'clock to your client, 10 minutes before you should be there. 10 minutes before you should be there. One day I was just, Mr. Jagannathan, he is Sambandhi of Justice D. Raju, Supreme Court Judge. You all people must be knowing, he is no more. Jagannathan. He just said the matter. I am just indicating small experience. 33 acres of lands in Maya, in this outskirts of the city were acquired by the Tamil Nadu Housing Board. They succeeded. Before the single judge they lost, division bench they succeeded. And then the Housing Board was preparing appeal in the Supreme Court. They requested me to enter caveat. And then I entered caveat, then the Housing Board filed the SLP. They wanted to discuss the matter with me. I just gave time, 2 o'clock. Believe me, I forgot. That is 2 o'clock, then I was very busy here and there. Fortunately, I look at my watch, then it was just 1:50. Then all right, I have other work. I thought, all right, I can go and meet these people. When I came, exactly 2 o'clock, the gentleman, thinking that I am very perfect in timing, it is only coincidence. Look at the timing. These judges, these Supreme Court lawyers are very perfect. That has made my life to think. Oh, people give more importance to the way you are behaving. There I was just discussing with my friends. There they said, see, amidst all your time, amidst all your schedule, you are able to come to us 2 o'clock, the time you are given. I realize, yes, we have to maintain the timing. If you don't do that, they may go to other people. Ultimately, you'll be the loser. Only thing is, you'll be losing lakhs of rupees only. One client will pay you unlimited amount. It all depends upon how you are moving. Honesty is more important. The man said, take away the money. I'm not meant for this additional fees. I have received my fees, I have done my work, and then you had a good case, you have been acquitted from the charges of 302. Anyway, I have done my work, that's all. No question of additional fees, get lost. You should have that ability, you should have that qualification and the quality. If you are able to, the entire people will come to you, they will be waiting for you. That is one of the very, very important fundamental thing you must possess. Come to the aspect of the next qualification. In the honesty we have seen, courage, you should have it. You are a neighbor, your neighbor is there. Somebody comes, a police commissioner and then collector, jointly they pass one order, detention order, branding a person as a gundas. If a person is branded as a gunda, and the detention order is passed, you all know that you cannot move a bail application. You must know that. Bail is not possible. You have to be inside the jail. In the sense, a client has to be inside the jail. If you see that, oh, this order has been passed by the collector. This detention order has been passed by the police commissioner. Oh, I'm terrified. I cannot challenge the order passed by the police commissioner. You should have the courage. Whether he is a police commissioner, or a collector, or a DGP, or whosoever, you have to see, is there any violation of law? That is the reason why people come to you. Do not bother whether a person, a higher ups have passed or a highest officer has passed the order. You should have the courage to challenge that. Provided you should have that idea, vision to look at the order, whether any error is there or any infirmity is there or any illegal elements are there, so that you can challenge it. That is the thing, you must see that. So you must have the courage. Third thing is industry. Friends, industry in the sense. In fact, Mr. Amal Raj was mentioning, I can cite only one example. I was, of course, born in a place where far away from this place, Tenur, a place where you cannot have good communication like you and I are enjoying here. It is only an ordinary school, Panchayat Union School, up to middle school. I was studying till 8th standard. Then 9th standard, 10th standard, I moved to the Madurai city. 9th standard, 10th standard, 11th standard, I was in a hostel. And then PUC, one college in Madurai, BA, Majora College, and then Law College, and then MA in Madurai Institute of Social Work. I kept on studying, then ultimately landed up in Law College. And then after completing my MA and completing my BL, I straight away came here. I wanted to practice because I thought of practicing the high court level so that I can get so many exposure, more exposures. When I came here, I was just fortunately attached with my senior friends. From the day one, I enrolled as a lawyer like you. From the day one, I did not face any hardships. I never felt that I was running short of money. It's a greatness. The lawyer, the senior office, the office which you are joining is more important. Understand one thing. I was practicing for some time. Very busy lawyer, very busy office. After 2.5 years, I thought of moving to Supreme Court because my uncle was there. He was working in United Nations. He is also from my place. He said, "All right, please come." What happened? He was having a close friend, one of the oldest law firm, R. Dignam & Company in Delhi. Fortunately, that R. Dignam & Company office is located on the Parliament Street. If you just come out, you can see the Parliament. Look at it. I'm a person, I've not even seen airport till I graduated to this level. I just came here. I used to come outside and used to see the Parliament building with my own eyes. They said, "All right, you have to go to, because you just now joined, better go to the Thesisari district court." Yes, all right. Because Delhi, to be in Delhi is a big affair. It's a fortunate days. Whichever the place you are asking me to go, I will go. Even police station, I'm prepared to go. Yes, I went to police station as a lawyer. I went to district court as a lawyer. And then what happened? One day I was just arguing a matter before. Sometimes I used to go to high court along with my friends because I want to see how the Delhi High Court is over there. Goes a friend from Calcutta. He was unable to come. 2-3 weeks he was off. I took over as a substitute. Friends, industry, I'm just talking about the how you must have the industry in your life as one of the very inseparable part of an advocate. I just worked out. I was arguing a case, and then after completing my argument, I was just coming out. It was during this summer days. I was keeping some files with my lawyer, my advocate's clerk. I was talking to him. And the file kudupa, adutha court ku ponom. That time, one Muralidharan, an IAS officer, a special commissioner to the Delhi government, he was also waiting for his case. After seeing that these two words, I just exchanged with my clerk. "Sir, you are from Tamil Nadu?" "Yes, sir." "I need a lawyer in the Pollution Control Board. I am the chairman of the Pollution Control Board. I want to talk to you. Can you come and meet me?" Look at it, how things are all going. So I do not know whether I impressed upon him while I was arguing the case before that bench. He was looking at me. It was a very ferocious entangle between me and the court. This gentleman, after seeing this man, and then after coming to know that he is a Tamilian, without hesitation, he came and said, "Sir, I am the special commissioner to the government of Delhi. Please come if you have time." Who will say that? Karumbudana Kuliyanra Madi. I just went to him. Then he said, he enrolled me as a woman of the, in the empanelment, I was one of the counsel. Career started. His friend, he is a chairman in the ESI Corporation. Look at it, after seeing the punctuality, seriousness which we devote, this gentleman said, "You can be a member in the ESI also." And then the problem is, if you become lawyer in the ESI Corporation, You have to go to the CAT, the Central Administrative Tribunal in Delhi. I said, all right, we'll see. I became the standing counsel for ESI Corporation in Delhi. The benefit is the multi-benefits. I have to go to the CAT. If I lose or win, the loser, the agreed person, will drag the matter to the Delhi High Court, and then from the Delhi High Court, they will go to the Supreme Court. Look at it, one brief, but three fees. And then what happened? I have studied the service law. What I am saying is, if you are able to be very smart, if you are able to demonstrate, exhibit your talents, and if you are very serious, you are industrious person, fortune will come to you. So at this stage, you should be sincere to the profession. If your senior tells you, yes, please do it, you take, you know, one day time, you must be in a position to complete the drafting within half a day, then he will pat you. This is how you have to show your alertness, smartness. Only then you'll be able to come into the mainstream of life. And this is the industry you must possess. You must be prepared to do your hard work. If you continue to sleep till 9 o'clock in your house, even after becoming a lawyer, and I don't think that even misfortune also will not come to you. Even misfortune will not come to you, because the man is with misfortune. Why should he go to this man now? So therefore, be smart and alert. Try to cultivate how to be. In fact, I was just sitting and then seeing one event in the TV. M.S. Viswanathan was just interviewed. He was saying, sir, I was in the limelight for 30 long years. MGR used to wait for me. Ganesan used to wait for me. Sridhar used to wait for me. But still, I was not able to keep time. You know why? I was sleeping only for 4.5 hours. You must know one thing. A man has reached a zenith. He can dictate terms with anybody. And he can sleep for 10 hours. But he continued to sleep only 4.5 hours. And today we remember him. Even the people who are going to top, you can't say, I will go back to my bedtime, I will change my bedtime. You must continue to be a hard-working lawyer. Only then you will be brought to limelight. This is a great profession. If you are smart enough, if you are industrious lawyer, if you are a hard-working lawyer, only then this profession will accept you as one of the legendary lawyer. And then he will keep you within the fold. Otherwise, you will be forgotten. And if you go to the next qualification, we have seen industry, that is hard work, eloquence. I must tell you one small example. What is eloquence? A lawyer has to speak properly with all clarity. You should have the clarity. You should have the ability to speak properly, the facts and the laws. I can tell you a small example. There was a person called Pandit Kanhailal Mishra. He was Advocate General of UP, Uttar Pradesh. This gentleman was former, the late Prime Minister of India, Indira Gandhi's lawyer. Look at the greatness of this lawyer. People used to say, at one point of time, he was unable to come to court because he has aged man. He has become very old age. The Indira Gandhi was elected from Allahabad. Her election was questioned before the High Court. Matter was going on. Ultimately, this man was not able to come, and then she lost in the High Court, Allahabad High Court. Another lawyer, Kare, has become lawyer of Indira Gandhi. People started saying, because of Kanhailal Mishra having become sick, Indira Gandhi lost the case. You all people, I'm just coming to the point. She imposed emergency. Look at the, see, you must know one thing. A lawyer who is conducting the case was unable to complete the case because he has fallen ill, bedridden. As a result, a client loses her case. Look at the ramification. Look at the impact of losing a case. Look at the impact of not getting a good lawyer. The country was facing emergency. Life and liberty of the persons were completely buried because of the emergency. Misused, many people misused. Let us not go to that area. I'm just mentioning about the importance of an advocate. Such is the greatness of this Pandit Kanhaiyalal Mishra. I need not go to Allahabad. I'll just come back to our Tamil Nadu. This gentleman, Pandit Kanhaiyalal Mishra, he was chosen to defend one case in the state of Maharashtra before the Bombay High Court. What happened? You all people must come to know one Blitz case. B-L-I-T-Z, Blitz case. In UP Assembly, State Assembly, proceedings were going on. R.K. Karanjia, he is one of the very reputed editor of this Blitz magazine. He has given a wrong reporting of what had happened in the UP Assembly. UP State Assembly is in Uttar Pradesh, but it has been some wrong reporting has been given in the state of Maharashtra. Of course, this Blitz is also having circulation in UP. This was brought to the notice of the Speaker of the Assembly. The Speaker of the Assembly, taking cognizance of this wrong reporting of the events that took place in the UP Assembly, he has passed the order of arrest against this R.K. Karanjia. He is one of the top leading, the senior most editor in the Blitz magazine. He was arrested. And then what happened? He was not produced within 24 hours as per Article 22, subclause 2 of the Constitution of India, which says that if anybody is arrested, that's a point you must know. If anyone is arrested in our country by a police, within 24 hours he should be produced before the nearest magistrate, minusing the time taken to travel. Whatever in this case, in the Karanjia's case, R.K. Karanjia's case, the police have taken more than 30 hours. They were not able to give explanation to justify the order of arrest and then remanding the gentleman to judicial custody. Since this order was passed by the Speaker of UP State Legislature, the UP State Legislative Speaker has passed his order, arresting a man who is living in Maharashtra, Bombay. A writ petition was filed in the Supreme Court under Article 32 of the Constitution of India. You know that the Constitution of India, under Article 32, it gives enormous power to the Supreme Court. You must know, as a lawyer, that Supreme Court is, under Article 32, is a custodian of the fundamental rights of the citizens. Under Article 226 of the Constitution of India, the High Courts are custodian of the citizens, custodian of the fundamental rights guaranteed by the Constitution of India. You can straight away go. Now what happened? This gentleman, since two states are involved, Maharashtra and then UP, they cannot maintain in one place because the Bombay High Court may not be able to give a direction to the state legislature or the police in UP. Therefore, straight away writ petition was filed before the Supreme Court under Article 32. The argument was advanced. Finally, briefly coming to the point, R.K. Karanjia succeeded. You know how? It was explained properly that as per Article 22, subclause 2 of the Constitution of India, if a person is arrested now, within 24 hours he should be produced before the nearest magistrate. Only with the authority of the magistrate, only the remand can be, judicial remand can be, judicial custody can be given. But in this case, more than 30 hours have taken place. Therefore, there is no justification for a delay. It should be quashed. See what happened? Supreme Court has allowed the writ petition, quashed the inner detention order, and then made an observation that there was a delay. Look at the beauty of the great lawyer. This gentleman was advised by Nani Palgiwala Karanjia, because Karanjia is a paperman, he is an editor. So you know that the paper people will be, the editors, the print media people will be keeping all big, you know, lawyers in their pocket. We all know that Nani Palgiwala, a Diana Bar, who has saved the democracy of the country, democracy of this great nation in the Kesavananda Bharathi. I do not want to waste time on that because time is very short time. Due to constraint of time, I'm just coming back to the topic now. Nani Palgiwala advised this man, yes, you got a wonderful observation from the Supreme Court. Your order of detention has been quashed. So therefore, you file a suit, claim damages from this state of UP. Suit was filed in the Bombay High Court because this man belongs to Bombay, belongs to Maharashtra. He filed a suit before the Bombay High Court. Friends, see, notice was issued. Pandit Kanaila Mishra comes to the picture. I'm just telling you, I want to make one point clear. You must come up to the level of Pandit Kanaila Mishra, or at least above him. Pandit Kanailal Mishra was engaged by the UP State Assembly or the UP State Government. Pandit Kanailal Mishra informed the Bombay High Court that on a particular date I will come and argue the case. The moment the message of Pandit Kanailal Mishra coming and appearing before the Bombay High Court, the matter was listed before one court, Justice Koyaji Court. I remember that. The matter was listed. Kanailal Mishra gave his appearance date, stating that, yes, Monday I will come and appear. Look at the greatness of this case. You must read, everybody. Blitz case. Palgiwala is appearing for R.K. Karanjia, who succeeded in the Supreme Court on the ground of delay. Observation goes in his favor that there is a delay. So on the point of delay, he is entitled to get compensation. For that, suit has been filed. Point number one. Kanailal Mishra is appearing, a great lawyer. Palgiwala is appearing for Karanjia. The another greatest lawyer is Sirvai, Hacham Sirvai. You people will come to know quickly because we know. In the High Court or Supreme Court, the lower judiciary, if there is any interpretation of the Constitution is involved, we always go to this Sirvai's Constitution interpretation, the rule of interpretation. Nobody knows what is the rule of interpretation except this gentleman, Sirvai. Every High Court, every Supreme Court, all the Supreme Court, they always give more importance to this Sirvai's Constitution interpretation. Nobody, no other judgment will touch it. Because this gentleman's interpretation is so precise, authoritative. Look at the greatness of this man. Sirvai, after knowing that this Pandit Kanailal Mishra is coming to Bombay High Court, this gentleman writes letter to the every bar association in the state of Maharashtra, informing them, look, wonder, miracle are going to take place in the court of Justice Koyaji. Please come and see, witness what this miracle is. What is the art of advocacy if you are a lawyer? This gentleman, look at this Sirvai, what is his stature? He will not allow anybody to overtake his reputation. His reputation has gone to the sky. But this gentleman, a lawyer has to give respect to the another lawyer. Please learn from this. This gentleman writes a letter to the entire Bar Association. Bar Association of Madras, Bar Association of Madurai, Bar Association of Salem. He writes, addressing them, wonder is going to take place, miracle is going to take place. You will come and witness what is the art of advocacy. Look at the second aspect. The law universities in Bombay declare holiday. You know why? A lawyer from UP, Allahabad, is coming to argue a case. you all people should go and listen and learn from him. Only then you will be able to know what is the art of advocacy. Look at it now. Law universities declare holiday. Bar Association also told these people, please go and see how this gentleman is going to argue. Can you just step into this Koyaji court when such an advertisement is given? People were thronging the entire high court. And then when huge crowd is flocking the court of Justice Koyaji, then the Bombay High Court also came to know, oh, this great gentleman, Pandit Kanhailal Mishra is coming. We will also go inside, but nobody was able to get inside because already it has been filled. Friends, the matter was taken up. Palgiwala, the greatest legendary lawyer, argued the case on the basis of the observation given by the Supreme Court in favor of his claim. We all know that Pandit Nani Palgiwala argues, he can't lose. He argued the matter. Then, in response, Pandit Kanhailal Mishra argued the case. He argued, the state government, in good faith, has passed the order of arrest. And then, while executing this order, the poor police people have committed mistake. Therefore, he cannot challenge. You cannot just find fault with the state government. You cannot maintain the suit for damages. This is one of the very important aspects. He said that if under one of the provisions, if any officer takes any steps or if he does any action, if there is any action, if there is any omission, if that is done in good faith, in the interest of the state, then you cannot hold him liable for damages. One of the provisions he cited, then many other things. And then after Mr. Pandit Kanhailal Mishra completed his argument, Mr. Sirvai has to argue for the Bombay police, because Bombay police only has arrested this R.K. Karanjia. He rose from his seat. If I were there, if Amal Raj or Chandrasekharan is there, we will argue. Because we have taken a chance before this particular bench, we will argue the case along with this man. Look at the greatness of this man. He said, he rose from his seat, Mr. Sirvai, and told the court, Lord, I do not want to tarnish the beautiful quoting given by Pandit Kanhailal Mishra. I am afraid if I am arguing any case, even if it is good, but the argument which Pandit Kanhailal Mishra has advanced before this court may even be cover up my argument, your lordship will forget. So therefore I respectfully adopt the argument of Mr. Pandit Kanhailal Mishra. Sirvai can say, Sirvai, the great lawyer, one time lawyer, nobody can be compared with the Sirvai. Sirvai said, look at the greatness of this man. Ultimately, Sirvai and Pandit Kanhailal Mishra won the case. Nani Palgiwala lost the case. And then the matter was taken up to the division bench. Chakla, the Chief Justice of Bombay High Court, he was sitting with another judge. Appeal was taken up. Again, Palgiwala comes to the court. Huge crowd. Look at the wording. Palgiwala opened his argument. He said, my Lord, I was having wonderful, wonderful case, my Lord. Such a case I would never come across. I was having the support of the Supreme Court observation in spite of which this learned single judge dismissed my case. Oh, learned single judge dismissed your case in spite of the observation given by the Supreme Court in your favor? Yes, my Lord, I have got a wonderful case, but in spite of it, I lost. Why? Look at the reply given. Lord, Mr. Pandit Kanhailal Mishra has mesmerized this court, my Lord. He never alleged anything. Look at the wording. He never said that he misrepresented the court. He has fraudulently manipulated like what you do. We are all immediately, Lord, fraud has been committed. Never said that. He said, look at the wording. Look at the politeness. Look at Thiruvalluvar's cruel kural is coming. He has used the sweetest word. He said, Lord, Pandit Kanhailal Mishra has mesmerized the learned single judge, Lord. That is the reason why I lost the case. I am before your lordship. Look at the reply of this, the great judge Chakla. He said, if Mr. Pandit Kanhailal Mishra, who is present here, has mesmerized the learned single judge, don't you think that he will be again mesmerized? Yes. Matter was dismissed, confirming the order passed by. after they heard the matter, and I'm just coming to the point. You should know how to conduct yourself. You should be in a position to read things now and then. Today, your days have started. Countdown started. Countdown started for your success. Every day, the moment you are just getting out from your bed, you must keep Constitution of India and CPC and any other branch where you are going to get in, you must have some reference. If not morning, at least before you go to bed. If you read at least one provision in your life, I'm sure nobody will be able to surpass you, and you will be able to surpass everybody. That you must know that. See, unless you have the secret of success, these are all the secret of success. You must try to imbibe, you must try to acquire these type of small things. And you see, one leaf will make a biggest forest. The one leaf will be added with other leaf, and then so many leaves will make big forest. Therefore, you try to learn from one day, one provision of law, and you will be able to become one of the legendary figure after some time. So it goes on like this. Judgment. When a client comes to you, you must be in a position to find out, this is the case, I am going to succeed. You can tell the client, these are all the points in your favor, I may try. If you are able to see that, yes, this is a very bad case, you are not going to succeed, there is all things, all the laws are all against you, you must be gracious enough to tell your client that, I see, you do not have a good case. And these are all things, therefore you must have the ability to judge your case. Every case is decided in the lawyer's chamber. In the lawyer's chamber, when your client comes and tells you, you will be in a position to know what is the weakness of your case, what is the strength of your case. You must be in a position to tell. And if you say that, yes, you have a 50-50 chance, you have 40% chance, 60% chance of losing. Tomorrow, if you are able to win also, and then you can say, yes, although he has indicated, he is able to get some order, and he will be happy with you. So it goes on like this. And then you have a duty as a lawyer. This great man, this Pandit Kanhaiyalal Mishra, I do not want to leave this man. Because you have to learn so many good things from this Dayanatha Bar. You all people will be knowing Ram Manohar Lohio. You must have read the history. Ram Manohar Lohio is one of the great leader in India, in North India, socialist leader. He was detained under the Gundas Act because he spoke in one of the meetings against the government, state government. He was detained. When he was just, his case was there, he wanted to argue the case. He was like the great leaders we had here. And then this gentleman said, I will argue the case myself. He came to the court. And then since Ram Manohar Lohio is the leader, socialist leader, like Jayaprakash Narayanan, when he is going to come, do you think that any government lawyer will be coming and appearing? Any additional advocate general will be coming and appearing? No, no. The government said, yes, Mr. Pandit Kanhaiyalal Mishra, please see that this Ram Manohar Lohio is coming and appearing party in person. Please go and defend the case on behalf of the state government. He came and appeared. I am just coming to one point. You owe a duty to the court. You owe a duty to the other side, other opponent side. Here is a case. Please take note of it. Ram Manohar Lohio comes and appears, party in person. He preaches the philosophy. He says that this order is wrong. But he was not able to cite any judgments. Pandit Kanhaiyalal Mishra was sitting to give his reply. And then the court said, there are some judgments, it appears, decided in your favor. We will give you time, 2-3 days time, please go and collect the judgment, give it to us. Matter was adjourned. Friends, this gentleman, Pandit Kanhaiyalal Mishra, went to his office, collected all the judgments in favor of Ram Manohar Lohio, and then also caught hold of some of the provisions in his support, went to jail to meet this Ram Manohar Lohio. And then after meeting this Ram Manohar Lohio in the jail, Pandit Kanhaiyalal Mishra explained to him, this is the judgment in your favor, this is the provision in your favor, you please come and argue the case. Friends, many people, this message has gone across the state. Pandit Kanhaiyalal Mishra, who is supposed to oppose this Ram Manohar Lohia, this man comes and then meets him in the jail and then he has been guiding him. The state government knows his capacity, his competence, his honesty. They can't question him. Are Ram Manohar Lohia and then Pandit Kanhaiyalal Mishra, can you just doubt his integrity or honesty? No. The moment you question his honesty, you will be losing his appearance. You will be losing his guidance. Nobody was able to whisper anything. That should be the atmosphere. That should be the gamut you must be in a position to establish. What happened? Matter was come next. And then everybody was asking, sir, Mr. Ram Manohar Lohia is your opponent. You are supposed to oppose his argument. But you went to him, you met him, sir, and you are just briefing him, you are guiding him. Friends, here is a case I want to make one point very clear. Mr. Pandit Kanhaiyalal Mishra said, the role of a lawyer is not only to win the case. All the time is not to win the case. The role of the lawyer is to assist the court and also assist the other side. When you are assisting the other side, you are assisting automatically the court. So when you are assisting the court, helping the court, fairly the court will be able to render a fair judgment. Therefore, do not think ever that a lawyer's role is only to win by hook or crook. No. Assist the court. Place the facts. Place the legal aspects. Only then you will be able to fulfill your commitment, your duty to the court. So therefore, let us learn from this type of small things. What is the role a lawyer, an advocate has to discharge? Goes on like this. And I can tell you many events and incidences like this. But one important thing I must tell you. Today, you all people have come and become part of the noble profession. You must be in a position to equip too much. The ground reality you must know. Today, there are three colleges have come up in the country. There is one college, law school, in IIT Kharagpur. One school of law has been opened. You will be surprised to see that. You must come to know how you are going to mold yourself. In the IIT Kharagpur, a very peculiar type of law school has come up. You know the admission criteria? You and I cannot get admission. Plus two is not the qualification for getting admission. A BE degree holder, B.Tech degree holder alone can get admission in this IIT Kharagpur Law School. You are disqualified. Tomorrow you cannot apply. That is one thing. And then similar law school has been opened in the Delhi Law School. There again the qualification is BE degree holder. A person who has got a BE degree alone can become lawyer. There is one more college, Kanpur. In Kanpur, there is one more law school that has been opened. Again, surprisingly, interestingly, the qualification is you must have the BTech qualification to get admission. Friends, these people, the engineers who are all coming to get law degree, we are all expecting these people will go back to their field, but these people are not going back to the engineering field, they are all staying with us. You can imagine. These people are drafting the petition and then these petitions are all filed before the special tribunals, the special forums like Electricity Appellate Tribunal, Cyber Law Tribunal and then Patent Law Tribunal. See, when these people are able to draft petitions indicating the 2G defects, the 3G technological defects, the 4G technological defects, and when they are able to know what is the medical negligence, do you think that you and other people will be able to compete with them? You may not be knowing what is the 2G, 3G or 4G, 5G technological defect. They will be far, far better than even many senior counsels. I do not want to name them. Today, the lawyers who are graduating, getting degree from this IIT Kharagpur Law School, the lawyers, the law students like you who are all coming out from this Kanpur Law School, the students coming out from this Delhi Law School, they are all completely wiped out, they are all completely hijacked by these all law firms. They are all offering several lakhs of rupees now. Even in the beginning, I'm just imagining one situation. Tomorrow, if these people are all coming and opposing against you, what will happen to your case now? Therefore, get ready. You must know what is earth signs. You must know what is the marine signs. You must know what is the life signs. And you must come to know what is technology and what is science. If you know only the provisions, you will be pushed out of the entire scope of this practice. You must equip yourself. Self-education is a more important thing you must acquire. Do not expect that your senior will be teaching this thing, that thing. You must try to learn what is science, what is technology. Only then you will be able to brief, you will be able to argue the case properly. Get ready. And then don't think that by just visiting a lawyer's office, the senior will be giving you a brief and you will be reading. Yes, of course. He will be giving you accommodation. No doubt on that. But the point is, look at the law schools. Three law schools they have come up. In addition to that, 25 law schools are all there in the state, in our country. Law universities are all there. In our Hyderabad, there is a law university, NALSA University. For the past 15 long years, 100% placement, the moment the school is, you know, the 5-year course is going to be over, all the law firms are coming and standing one after the other. Look at the scope of lawyers, the importance of lawyers have been realized by even the law schools, even by the corporate companies, the multinational companies. Like the engineering colleges, they are all coming and holding the campus interviews. When they are coming and holding every year the campus interview, 100% placement, all the 100 students are all hijacked by these multinational companies as their executives, law executives. If they are coming and some of them are coming to practice, if they are coming and practice, where you people will go? Unless you are equipping yourself, you must come on par with these people. Therefore, I do not want to take more time because I have taken more than sufficient time. So I wish you all the best. Try to come up to the expectation of the bar. I mentioned to you that today lawyers are commanding regards, respects, goodwill, reputation, which nobody at any point of time has enjoyed. Today the time has come. If you want to become a legendary lawyer, the future is in your hand. Keep it in mind that these IIT Kharagpur students, the Kanpur Law School students, and then the Delhi Law School students are also going to compete with you. When they are coming and standing and opposing in your case, you must be in a position to conquer them. For that, you have no other option. You have to equip yourself. Time is not far off. I mentioned to you, Hari Salve has paid 100 crores in the year 2012 as the professional tax to the government exequer. That is bigger than the revenue of Amitabh Bachchan, Bollywood superstar. Similarly, look at the case of our present Attorney General, Mr. K.K. Venugopal, Mr. Parasaran, from our place, from our High Court, Arvind Dattar, Mr. Arima Sundaram, Mr. Gopal Subramaniam, they are all from your place, from our High Court, from your place. They are all the highest tax-paying lawyers. Mughal Rotagi, Soli Sarabji, Mr. Fali Nariman. Everybody is making huge money, tons and tons of fortunes. Why, how? Is a question you have to ask yourself. And you are able to see that you will be able to succeed. And fortunately, and soon, a day will come, you will also join this elite group. With that, I congratulate all of you. Wish you all the best to become a legendary lawyer. Thank you for the opportunity given to me.
Honorable Judge for his thought-provoking advice to new entrants who are all enrolled today. I invite Mr. M. Velmurugan, Member Bar Council of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry, to propose vote of thanks.
My Lords, as your Lordship lastly observed that you have taken so much of time in making this special speech. Honestly speaking, such a delightful speech and a very inspiring speech, nobody would have felt that your Lordship has taken so much of time. Every words of your Lordship, if any person, everybody who has today enrolled is going to take the words or adapting the words your Lordship has made. Definitely they will be reaching the greatest heights as Lordship was mentioning so many legendary persons. Your Lordship has been an epitome of success, and your Lordship has hailed from a smallest village of Tamil Nadu, the Thennur village, and your Lordship has been seen as an epitome of success, and every one of you are blessed with these excellent words delivered by His Lordship, and you are all really truly blessed because such an inspiring speech your Lordship has delivered. On behalf of our Bar Council, we wholeheartedly thank your Lordship for such a wonderful and delightful speech. I thank our Chairman, Mr. P.S. Amalraj, for arranging our special judge today. It's been a very inspiring speech. Definitely, though it has taken 1.5 hours, nobody has felt that it has taken so much of time. We enjoyed every moment of your Lordship speech. I thank our Chairman, and I thank our Enrollment Committee member, Mr. Prabhu, and I thank who has taken this efforts in the last 3-4 months. Though due to the pandemic situation, we were facing so much of difficulties in organizing this enrollment. The credit goes to our enrollment committee for taking steps to not to deny the opportunity of young lawyers, and with the support of our secretary, and with I thank Mr. Rajkumar, the secretary, who has taken so much of efforts in conducting this enrollment event, and I thank our member co-chairman Mr. Saravanan for making the felicitation speech, and I thank Mr. Chandran Lawton, last but not least, our member Mr. Chandrasekhar, who is the standing counsel, who was also instrumental in arranging our special speaker, Honorable Justice T. Raja. I once again thank everybody, and I wish every persons who have enrolled today a great success. I believe today, after hearing this speech, definitely you will be inspired so much. You will be reaching greatest heights. I thank you, everybody. Thanks very much.
Thank you, sir. I request you all to rise for national anthem.